recognized symbol of excellence in sports entertainment.
Hello, everyone, and welcome. Gorilla Monsoon here at ringside for the New England Sports Network, along with my dear friend and colleague, His Lordship Alfred Hayes, filling in for the Jesse the Body Ventura, who is on special assignment, Lord, for the World Wrestling Federation, but no one knows where.
I wonder where he did go.
Who the heck knows? Plenty of action coming out of the Boston Garden. Big, tremendous tag team match. The Junkyard Dog teams up with the Hulk against the Funk Brothers, and Tito tries to get his title back. Let's go up to our ring announcer right now.
This match is one fall with a 20-minute time limit. First from Nice, France, weighing 236 pounds, the number one Frenchman, René Goulet. Samoa, weighing 238 pounds, Stevie Afi.
Hello, everybody, and welcome. Gorilla Monsoon here with Lord Alfred Hayes, filling in for the on assignment, special assignment, Jesse the Body Ventura. You know where he is, Lord.
Well, I have an idea, but I wouldn't like to say so because I might be wrong. And if I was wrong, you know what Jesse's like.
Yes, obviously so. It's No one can ever tell where the body goes when he goes on special assignment, but we're here in the fantastic Boston Gardens, jam-packed to the rafters. Take a look. There they are. Some 20,000 plus streamed in here for this tremendous World Wrestling Federation extravaganza.
And they know they're in for a good time this evening with this fantastic card that's lined up for them.
Well, starting off with Stevie Afi, the young Samoan newcomer here to the World Wrestling Federation, doing very well for himself, Lord.
He is. At the moment, his record is without blemish. And if he can maintain that, he's going to be a force
to be
reckoned
with. He's in there with a crafty guy tonight.
Yes, indeed. Goulet.
René Goulet.
Knows
the number one Frenchman.
Absolutely. Knows and uses every inch of the ring.
I like to call him the Michael Jackson of the wrestling world, with his little sequined glove.
Does he still have that on?
Oh, he had it on earlier. Now he's reaching into his tights for what appears to be a driving glove or a handball glove or a golf glove of some kind. Referee checking it over.
He seems satisfied with it, so I don't see that that's any additional advantage for Goulet, only psychological.
Well, it may give him a little extra way to hang on when he slaps that Scorpio claw hold on, Lord. Maybe.
Yeah, well, he's very adept with that claw hold, and he has won some very, very decisive battles with it.
Well, of late here, I would say the past 6 or 7 months here in the World Wrestling Federation, he's more or less thrown it to the wolves.
Absolutely.
He hasn't won a match with it in 6 months, Lord.
But he took
not too good in the record books.
No. But he took Siviafi down nicely on his head just then, if you notice.
Well,
good opening move.
I don't honestly believe that claw hold, the particular one that he uses, would be effective on this youngster. He's got very thick forehead.
Yes.
Jesse said one night that he's thick between the ears, you know. But he didn't mean it that he had a wide forehead. He meant that the guy didn't have too much gray matter.
I wonder why Jesse would say a thing like that. He's usually not that insulting, is he?
Nice arm wringer by Goulet. Steps over. Nice takedown. Crafty René Goulet, ring veteran for some 15, 16, maybe 18 years, Lord.
Yes, and once again, he rammed Siffy Afi's head into the mat there. So Afi's going to have to watch those maneuvers that Goulet is forcing him into on his head each time. He's got to be thick there.
Hey, no, when there's ever a card of great importance, as there is always here in the World Wrestling Federation, René Goulet is on it. Nobody home. CP snuck out the back door. He didn't really take advantage of the situation, though. He's not that kind of a youngster.
No. And I think at the moment, CV is relying on the sportsmanship of Goulet, and I don't think that's the right thing to do.
No, definitely not. Some kind of a tattoo on the right hamstring or quadricep of the young Samoan.
Yes.
Either that or it's an awful scar, one of the two, Lord. You know,
no,
my eyesight, Jesse's always questioning my eyesight, but it's either a tattoo or a scar. Let me put it to you that way.
It is.
Oh,
it looks
there
like
it is.
Some exotic flower.
Looks
or
like
leaf.
A maple leaf, maybe.
Yeah. Do they have those in Samoa?
I doubt it, very seriously.
Some little bit of foliage, anyway.
Rene using some leverage here to get a one count, not a pinning combination. Afi not in any danger of being pinned with that.
No, both men very tentative right now, seeking the weakness of each other.
Well, I think it, you know, Goulet has everything to gain and nothing to lose, Lord. Where on the other hand, Afi has got an undefeated record going for himself. Rene Goulet, I think, stopped counting a long time ago. Oh, nice shoulder block. Sends the Frenchman down to the canvas. Up quickly, dropped down in front. Youngster was over there in a hurry. Look at this takeover. Wow.
Three nice moves put together there by the young Samoan, and very, very devastating, too. That high maneuver when he brought Goulet over must have taken its toll on the Frenchman because he's just laying there at the moment.
Boy, he's really jerking up on that side headlock.
Uh-huh.
Give you cauliflower ear, something that I managed to get through without, Lord.
Well, I've got one, so I was halfway there.
Boy, I've heard so many guys complaining night after night about the tremendous pain involved with the cauliflower ears. And for me, it was easy, 6 foot six, and I didn't want to stay in those headlocks very long. You grabbed a headlock, you were in deep trouble with me.
Well, they could find my head pretty easily.
Still hanging on to the side headlock. Rene trying to find a counter that'll work.
Some nice wearing down moves by the Samoan. Hanging on to that headlock. Powerful arms, the Samoan.
Goulet went to the tights, Lark.
Yes.
Right into the tights. Sunset flip, got the legs hooked over. No. Well, Goulet was on his feet. The referee was making the two count.
Goulet is moving very, very fast. He's shed some weight in these last few months, and it's paying off for him. He seems to be a lot speedier than he was just a couple of months ago.
No question about that. He dropped about 27 pounds total, and that increased his speed but took away some of his strength. Lord.
Yes, but sometimes that's a better thing. He's a thinking type wrestler, Goulet, and he'll try and outsmart his opponent, and if he's carrying a lot of excess weight, he's not going to do that.
Still holding on to this side headlock. CV Afi.
I'm very impressed with this youngster from Samoa.
And he knows how to wear those knee pads. That impresses me. Not many guys do. Knee right to the lower abdomen. Notice he wears them down around the calf, Lord. That's the proper place to wear a knee pad. Not above the knee or covering the knee. That way, when you go down, that knee pad absorbs the pressure on the patella.
Yes. I wish I'd have known that 20 years ago.
You might have been moving around a little better today, right?
Yes, very definitely.
He certainly got a shot to that lower abdomen area, and Rene is going to work on it right now. But the youngster has tremendous resiliency, as I'm sure we'll see as this match goes on.
He really does. He has that durability that those Polynesians seem blessed with. He's endowed with a lot of strength, and he has a lot of heart, too.
Well, the one that brings to mind to me, Lord, is Peter Maivia, who has since passed away. But Peter had that resiliency that he could take tremendous amounts of punishment and still manage to survive.
Yes, he hung in there all the time. He's like a bulldog, wasn't he, Maivia? Oh. Incredible strength and ability to hang on at all costs.
And if something went wrong in the parking lot, I'd want him on my side.
Definitely.
Avi in for the ride. Whoa, what a clothesline by Goulet. Caught the youngster sleeping a little bit.
Very
over for a cover, he won't get him. No way. He had his body weight way out of balance, Lord.
Yes, but he's making the Samoan think a lot more.
There it is.
Goes.
He slapped it on. He has not thrown it in the garbage. He's back with that claw hole once again. We'll see how successful he can be with it. Goulet has slapped it on.
And he's punishing the Samoan, and the Samoan looks as if he's weakening a bit. Sivi better try and pull himself together.
He's got to get to his feet here to alleviate that downward pressure. The lights will go out in a hurry. Shoulders are down. The referee could be counting them out, Lord. He's not.
I think he's got a good sight on his shoulders there, actually. So maybe they're not quite as down as we think they are.
Well, they look pretty flat to me.
Well, that right shoulder definitely looks as if it's down.
Well, obviously, the referee thinks that this is a submission hold, and it really isn't, because you can get your shoulders counted down with it as well. Oh, the youngster battling back now. That'll help a lot. He's got to his knees and now to his feet. Rene will have a tough time holding onto it now. And the Frenchman has to break it. Look out, Goulet. Oh! There's that craftiness coming out on the part of Rene Goulet. He's going to slap it on again, this time from the second turnbuckle. Yes, no.
There is no substitute for experience, and that is what the Frenchman is showing right now. A lot of experience.
Oh, look at that. He saw a couple fingers laying out there where they weren't supposed to be.
And he's soon stumped on those. Oh.
Not too much behind those shots by Sifi. He's hurt. And Goulet has slapped down the claw hole once again. Handful of hair helps take the youngster down to the canvas.
Things are not going too well for Sifi right at this moment.
Why do guys put their names on the back of their tights, Lord, in case they leave them in the locker room or something? Never understood that.
No, I don't. Maybe he forgets who he is occasionally.
Maybe.
It's behind him.
He'd have a hard time reading it, though.
It's behind him.
It's all behind him now, yes. Rene Goulet going to work with the Scorpio claw hold. Hasn't been too successful for him in the past, but he hasn't forsaken it, Lord.
No, and he's looking extremely confident. And he should do, because he's had the last 5 minutes all to himself here. Afi hasn't been able to offer a lot of resistance to Goulet's attack.
Sort of been a one-way street.
It really has.
Boy, the entire wrestling world, Lord, buzzing, talking about WrestleMania 2.
Isn't that incredible?
The happening, coming down Monday, April 7th. The biggest closed-circuit extravaganza of and live bouts everywhere. Chicago, Los Angeles, Nassau Coliseum, New York. Tremendous, tremendous event.
Millions and millions of people will see this. It's the biggest thing ever, ever to happen in wrestling, and it's the most fantastic thing.
I understand in the 20 foreign markets as well, Lord.
Yes, it is, and in different languages the world over.
Well, we have quite a contingency here with us in the Boston Garden as far as news media people are concerned. We'll get a shot of some of them later on here covering this World Wrestling Federation bout. Uh-oh, lefts and rights now, and Sifi won that battle.
Yes, Goulet made a mistake there. He was doing so well with his wrestling. He should have stuck with that.
Goulet now being rammed into that top turnbuckle time and time again, maybe a dozen times. Oh, big roundhouse right misses, and Sifi with an atomic drop. Uh-oh, a little war dance going on now by the Samoan.
Samoan's turned the tables on him.
Goulet doesn't
rapidly
know exactly where he is. Frenchman in for the ride. Big backdrop. Wow.
Whoa, high backdrop.
Look out below. Headbutt down for the cover. Does not hook the leg. Couldn't get him. Rene had those arms doubled up underneath him and managed to kick out. Now an eye gouge stops the Samoan dead in his tracks. Another roundhouse right missed. High cross body. One count, two. Now a handful of tights saved the Frenchman that time.
Stevie showing an experience here by not hooking that leg. He could have beaten him twice then. Didn't take that leg on either occasion, and now the Frenchman's still in there battling it up.
Oh, reversal, reversal, reversal. And Goulet, head first in, look out. Off he going to the outside. Perhaps to go all the way up. Rene Goulet stunned in the center of the ring.
But partially to his feet.
Look out. High cross body, down goes Goulet. He's got the leg hooked. This one's history.
Fantastic move by the Samoan there.
Still undefeated, Sifi Afi. Let's get the official word.
Here is your winner, Sifi Afi.
Sifi Afi, a tremendous victory over ring veteran Rene Goulet, who is really stunned. Take a look at the look on his kisser. Let's go back if we can and take a look. Rene Goulet missed with a big right hand here, and now Rene doesn't know where he is. He turns around and look at this. Talk about your flying birds. Caught him with a knee right in the kisser,
nice
Lord.
Move. Beautiful move. Caught him with that knee, knocked him senseless, and that's the result.
Wow.
One, two,
tremendous
three.
Victory for that youngster right there from the Samoan Islands. Don't go away, wrestling fans. We'll be back.
This match is one fall with a 20-minute time limit. First from Puerto Rico, weighing 249 pounds, Jose Luis Rivera. His opponent from Stone Mountain, Georgia, weighing 259 pounds, Jake the Snake Roberts.
Jake the Snake Roberts making his debut here in the Boston Garden for the World Wrestling Federation. but certainly no stranger to the squared circle.
Certainly not. The last time I saw Jake the Snake was in South Carolina in Columbia, and he was very, very impressive. A very quick victory he made there in about 5 minutes. He had the whole place in an absolute uproar, and it wasn't just because of a snake.
Well, let's get our number five camera to take a good shot. There it is. A good shot of that very ominous looking bag sitting over there in the corner. And there's no telling what's in there, Lord.
Really? You know, for one who loves snakes like Jake does, I wonder why he wears those snakeskin boots. I mean, there's a dead snake. I can't imagine why anybody would do that.
Oh, they're probably artificial.
Oh, hi. You know,
he's been known to be
do you think so?
Tight-fisted, so to speak.
Well, I know his father was.
Yes. Had short arms and deep pockets.
Yes.
But certainly is a first-class A1 wrestler with a very impressive record coming into the World Wrestling Federation here. And he's going to make trouble for a lot of guys. Whoa!
Yes, he is. But at the moment, he should not underestimate Jose Luis Rivera, because he's a very smart wrestler indeed. Rivera's already upset a few budding careers.
Jake the Snake slips underneath. Oh, Rivera nicely over the back. Wow. Very quick.
Isn't he, though? Very quick, very elusive. And
oh, look at this. Inverted backbreaker right on those lower abdominal muscles. They'll take the starch out of anybody in a hurry.
Knock the wind right out of you, and if he happens to catch his knee in the lower ribs, he can easily separate the intercostus there.
Rivera will know he's been in a battle before this one's over. Speaking about battles, Lord, that tremendous battle royal, that open invitational, part of WrestleMania 2 coming down in Chicago, April 7th. There are some guys in there that have nothing whatsoever to do with wrestling.
Absolutely. Have you seen some of the names?
Oh, we're talking about William the Refrigerator Perry, Bill Frelick from the Atlanta Falcons, Russ Francis, good friend of yours, Lord.
Yes, absolutely.
Jimbo Colbert, Too Tall Jones, Harvey Martin. Holy mackerel, can you imagine those guys stepping inside the squared circle without a helmet on?
I just can't wait to see this. And no suits of plastic armor either.
Well, some of those guys are quite huge, Lord. But don't forget, also in that battle royal in Chicago will be Andre the Giant, Big John Studd, Ted Arcidi, World's Strongest Man.
Yes.
It's going to be a happening.
Jumbo Jim Convert is a big, big man, but I think he's going to be surprised by the size of Studd, Andre the Giant, and as you say, Arcidi.
Rivera doing well for himself, but the snake dropped out quickly. Wow, and caught him right underneath the sternum.
Doesn't he move fast?
He certainly does. I thought Rivera was fast, but Jake the Snake has got it on him. He's not going to get Rivera that way.
No, a little
haphazard cover there.
Yeah, but I think that's a little psychological warfare there. He's just showing Rivera that he can get into that pinning position if he wants to.
Lord, I want to make the point clear and emphasize to the fans that no matter where they go to view WrestleMania 2, they will see all the top attractions out of the Nassau Coliseum, all the top attractions out of the Horizon in Chicago, and all the top attractions out of the Los Angeles Sports Arena, or from wherever they are.
Yes, all by the big bird up in the sky, huh?
The big satellite will do it all. It's going to be a happening, a one-of-a-kind event. I thought WrestleMania 1 was the greatest wrestling extravaganza of all time, but believe me when I tell you that WrestleMania 2 will definitely surpass that.
I was going to top it. And now I heard a rumor, I don't know how true this is, but they're actually trying to get it into Moscow.
Into Moscow.
That's what I heard.
Well, I don't know whether the satellite could penetrate the Iron Curtain or not. We'll have to find out. We'll go to our very special correspondent for that information, a Nelson Swagler, and try to get that.
What do you say, Nelson?
Yet.
Yet. Look out. Nelson.
Oh, what a slam. Wow. He just drove him down into the canvas.
Oh, Roberts is about 6'6", and oh!
Rivera had an eye on him. There's two elbow drops missed, and you can bet that landing on that funny bone is not all that funny, Lord.
No, and for once, his speed wasn't helping him at all there. Robert's speed, in fact, was a handicap there because he came in much too quickly, and Rivera was ready for him.
I think maybe Jake the Snake may have underestimated Jose Luis Rivera.
Yes. As we said right at the beginning of this bout, he's upset a few budding careers. fact, he had a good run of victories just last month and the month before Rivera.
Yes, he did, and then he met with disaster.
Yes, it all, the wheels came off suddenly along the right.
One of these rungs on the ladder broke and tumbled Jose Luis Rivera. Now he's on the comeback trail once again.
Yeah, I think he hit his jaw on every run coming down, too.
But he's a comer. He's not a quitter.
No, he's a...
He's got about 6 months to feed at home. He better not be a quitter.
No. He's not all that...
Oh, look at the snake. He's trying to reach that bag, Lord.
Oh, you don't think he'd go inside that bag?
He's making a motion for that bag.
For the snake, do you?
Uh-oh, handful of hair is going to get him out of this armbar. Rivera ducks underneath the right hand and a high cross body.
Oh,
snake down, no. Close but no cigar. Look at the slithering action. Here are the snake as he slithers underneath that bottom rope, looking for a little breather here. There's no timeouts in the world of professional wrestling. I'm sure he's aware of that. But he can slither around like a snake.
He does slither, doesn't he? I wonder if he's got scales on him somewhere for slithering around like that.
Both of these men in excellent physical condition. You don't have to worry about either one of them running out of gas.
No, there's not a spare ounce
of... Not like when you and I entered the ring. If it was over a 12-minute time limit, we were in deep trouble.
Well, I was. I don't know so much about you.
Rivera hanging on for dear life to the arm wringer. He knows he's hurt that left arm. He wants to keep working on it. He's going to have to break it now. Wow. Right underneath the heart, that kick was.
Well aimed. Good aim. Quite precise.
Beautiful maneuver. Jose Luis thought he was going for a ride, and just about two steps backward, the snake put the brakes on and clothesline him.
And full force, too. That was a good
Look
move
at this.
By Roberts.
He removed some tape, looked like from his left wrist. Maybe he figured maybe that was cutting off the circulation. I got news for him. Oh. It's Rivera been working on that arm that's cut off the circulation.
Almost a one-hand this time. He's got a lot of sinew strength, Roberts.
Oh, he said the big knee's coming.
Uh-huh. Oh, very
He's
good.
Measuring him.
He's a little overconfident maybe here.
Oh, nice knee lift right in the kisser.
Good timing, too. Precise timing.
Having a good time. Big smile on his face.
Well, that may change shortly because Rivera's not down and out by any means yet.
Ah, form of a sleeper here. Half Japanese and half Australian.
Yes.
Kind of a hybrid.
I don't know whether Jake can make
he let it go, Lord.
Yes, he did. I don't think he was making a great deal of impression with that sleeper hold because Rivera wasn't sinking at all.
Thinking or sinking?
Sinking.
Sinking.
I don't know whether he can think, but he certainly wasn't sinking.
I'm not sure that he's, you know, Rivera doesn't even realize how close he is to those ring ropes. He could reach right. That's a choke now. Definite choke hold. It's underneath the chin. Come on, referee. Get in there. Take a look at that. That guy's got... Oh, now he switched it back. He had a choke hold on there.
Yeah, I think we've got a crafty one here in Roberts.
Rivera's not going to give up, Lord. He's not a quitter.
No, he doesn't seem to have the right leverage somehow or other in that hold.
Jake Snake Roberts having a rough time, a rougher time than I thought he would have with Jose Luis Rivera.
I think he thought he was going to have a nice, easy ride here, but he's not by any means.
It's never a night off in the World Wrestling Federation.
No, certainly not. And not with Rivera anyway, because he's a really good, gifted, and talented wrestler.
Well, he's back on it again, trying to wear him down some more. He's really making him carry his body weight, too. That's what saps you. That's what drains you.
Yes, he's not going to let Rivera up from the mat. He's going to keep him down there and wear him down because his speed wasn't making any impact upon, or impression, I should say, upon Rivera. He went for a couple of close pinfalls in the early part of this match. Didn't have much idea of holding on to him because he didn't hook the leg. And consequently, Rivera is still there.
Well, Rivera needs to hook that arm and turn this thing around into a hammerlock and get himself a little bit of breathing space here. A couple of sit-outs and turn-ins may turn him loose, but he's got to do some... Go to the ropes if you have to, Lord.
Yes, absolutely.
But get out. At any cost, get out.
Yes, a little tactics.
You know, my father always said, if you can't get five, take two. And if you're going to be a bear, be a grizzly. Oh, desperation move, clothesline shot by Jose Luis. Caught the snake right in the kisser. Look at that. Fell out backwards between the ropes, almost went to the floor. And Rivera now found some newfound energy from somewhere. That adrenaline's got to be flowing. Snake in for the ride. Big back to... Oh, look at that slithered out again, Lord. Yes. The snake. Rivera's right after him.
He may have made a mistake here.
Oh, Rivera got caught coming through the ropes.
He did make a mistake.
Uh-oh, the snake says now we're going to see it.
Yes.
He has a tremendous finishing hold that he uses. There it is, right there.
A brain buster.
It's called DDT. And he says he's worked 4.5 years to patent it. And he laid it on Rivera, who's out cold. It's over. Look at him slithering over towards that bag. What's he going to do with it? He wants to open it up. The referee's saying, no, you can't do that. I don't know why he can't do that.
I don't know either. Is there some sort of rule against that? Or is he, I presume he has his snake in there.
Alfred, that bag is moving around without anybody touching it.
That's rather...
Give you a sign of something.
Yes.
The referee definitely not allowing him to go into that bag. Let's get the official word.
The winner of this match, Jake the Snake Roberts.
Getting his hand raised, but he's not happy. He wanted to open that bag. Referee said no. He slithered that out of the ring.
He's been doing a lot of slithering.
Not happy, slithering out once again. Jake the Snake Roberts got a victory using his patented DDT hold as he flattens Jose Luis Rivera, but unable to get into the gunny sack. We'll be back, don't go away.
This is a special ladies tag team attraction. One fall with a 30-minute time limit. First, team number one, from Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, weighing 165 pounds, Donna Kristentala. Her partner from Myrtle Beach, weighing 161 pounds, Judy Martin.
Chigusa, or who's who?
No, they both look the same to me anyway.
You know, I thought maybe the lioness would have a little longer hair or something, but and maybe both, the striped tights is a
they're
clue.
Both wearing black karate belts as well, so I expect to see a lot of karate in play, but their publicity, their record is absolutely unparalleled. So we'll see if they can live up to that here in the United States of America.
Maybe we can get referee Danny Davis's attention and have him ask them, who's the lioness, Danny? Who's the lioness on this team? Who is the lioness? Aha, the blue is the lioness. Okay, we got it, Lord.
Right. Gosh, she does look like a lioness, too.
Very tigerish.
She looked at me just then, who kind of withered me.
Lioness stepping out, and Chigusa Nagoya about to start this match with Judy Martin. And Judy making sure that Danny knows the rules about the long hair, because the Japanese girls don't have any.
No, they don't, and that Japanese girl is poking her hand out to shake hands. She's in for a rude awakening from Judy Martin. Judy's not going to stand for that.
Judy Martin, one of the premier girl wrestlers here in the United States and all over the world, for that matter. Ranked very highly for a title shot at the Fabulous Moolah.
Yes, these Japanese girls, they look as if they know what they're doing. Already they haven't come to any clinches yet, but they certainly look as if they know
Well, I'll tell you what,
precisely
they've got
what is
amateur
needed.
Wrestling footwear on, Lord, which tells me something.
Yes. Their music was pretty stirring too, was it not?
It wasn't a piece that I was familiar with, Lord. Was it from Madame Butterfly or what?
I don't think so. I don't think it was from the Mikado either. Uh-oh. Donna doesn't like that.
Donna wants timeout. Donna, there is no timeout. I'm sorry.
She'll do anything, though, to distract. Absolutely anything. Donna and Judy make a very, very good ladies' team.
Crush Girls in from Japan for a very lengthy tour of the United States.
Well, it might
come in with some heavy credentials.
Yes, and it might suddenly stop.
Oh, look at the
nice
kip
move.
Up. Excellent kip up by Chiguza. Look at how Judy said, let me get out of here. Donna in here. She's been around longer. Oh, nice backward somersault right into a hammerlock.
Nice reversal. These Japanese girls are young, and but they don't necessarily look inexperienced.
No, they don't. Taking a chin lock with it. Nice maneuver takes Donna down to the canvas.
You know, this must be an ordeal for them because it's the first time they've ever wrestled here in the United States of America. And let's face it, this is the number one in ladies wrestling.
I think it's the first time they've ever left Japan, Lord.
Could be. Could be.
And when they decided they were going to come to the United States, they only wanted to come one place, and that's where the World Wrestling Federation was.
Absolutely.
They know that this is the Mecca. Oh, what is this? Japanese football stance.
Well, it certainly wasn't a sumo stance, was it?
No, definitely not. Judy backing into the corner, very reluctant to tie up.
I don't think they can figure out these girls' style. They're not just linking up. They're looking for an opportunity to attack. Yeah.
The lioness is in there now. Lioness Asuka.
Ooh.
Oh, that was a nice high karate kick, but no one there out of the reach.
No. Judy's a very quick young lady. She can move very rapidly. A very experienced girl, and it's going to show with this lioness.
Whoa! Danny Davis is saying that's all right, that's a legal move here in the United States. Maybe that's illegal in Japan, but it's perfectly legal here. Reverses with the arm wringer. Oh, and a karate kick of her own, and another one right in the lower abdomen area, and still a third one. And Judy just said, let me out for a while.
Yeah, she bails out. She's pretty shocked at what's happening right now. I don't think Judy's used to being treated in such an offhand manner. She's an aggressive wrestler herself, and now she's being treated aggressively by the lioness.
Tremendous news contingency here from Japan to cover all of these matches that the Crush Girls are in. They'll get a real education to Western style wrestling, Lord. Although in Japan, they do wrestle our rules.
Yes, they do.
Maybe I can hook up with him on the way back, Lord. I haven't been there since 1976. I'd be anxious to see some of the changes that have taken place.
Yes, that would be very interesting.
Maybe I could manage to get you to come along.
Well,
if I
just,
get you to
just
keep
to watch.
Up. Strictly as an observer, of course.
Yes, I don't think I could handle those chopsticks again.
Uh-oh, Judy going now, starting to unload on the lioness, who may be heading for the den shortly.
Yes, because Judy's taken command of this situation.
A little bit of a weight difference here, too. Hard into the corner. Oh, right up on top. Puts it with a sunset flip. Whoa, was that close?
Look at Judy. She
Donna didn't
she
even
didn't
have
like
a chance
that.
To get in. Chiguza rushing down the line to tell Danny Davis, look, they got
that is
by
the wrong thing to do.
In the meantime, no tag made. And Donna Cristinello in there now with a front face lock on the lioness.
Judy and Donna are a good team together, and they'll work this referee on his blind side, and he won't know whether he's coming or going.
Look at Donna now reaching in underneath to grab a handful of hair. The unsuspecting Danny Davis.
Oh, heavy boot there to the chest.
Big right hand by Donna, and the lioness manages to tag Chiguza Nagoya in there once more.
What was that name again?
Chiguza
Chigusa Nagoyo.
Yes.
Does that have any significance?
From parts unknown in Japan. Step over Toho by Donna. Oh, got a handful of tights from the blind side of the referee. Danny Davis, one of the premier referees here in the World Wrestling Federation.
That was a neat little move by Chigusa.
Chigusa. Hai, domo arigato. Tag made quickly. Judy Martin steps in. I'm sure she'll go to work on that same left leg.
Throws her into the rose rope. She's going to go.
Oh, nice duck underneath. Off the ropes hard. High cross body. She caught her in midair. Oh, drop kick by the lioness. But no. Oh. She could have hung on there.
Yes,
maybe got
I
a
think
three
so.
Count.
I don't know what she was doing there because she let go. But
Judy wound up again. Ooh. Whoa, what a karate shot. Full force behind that one. And an elbow.
Tagging Lioness, and Judy's taken off. She was really treated.
Lioness has been
most aggressively
in.
There.
Asuka in there now, waiting for some competition.
I think the Japanese girls could have finished that if they'd have been able to hang on to Judy, but Judy's a wily, wily woman.
Well, Donna and Judy were out now doing public relations, saying hi to some of the ringside fans.
Yeah, and meantime,
I'm sure there
was sucking
some,
in that breath.
Very derogatory statements made over there. I'm glad we didn't pick any of them up.
Well, they're ladies. They don't make derogatory statements,
no.
Do they?
Donna said, look, let's be friends.
Yeah. Yeah, and I think she's got her fingers crossed behind her back, too.
Donna Cristantello, Pittsburgh, PA. Been around the World Wrestling Federation for quite some time. Knows all the ins and outs.
I wonder if these Japanese girls understand any English at all.
It's hard to tell, Lord.
It is. I hear them speaking Japanese to each other, but...
Oh, there's an illegal move right there. Can't get too close to that corner. You've got to stay out of the opposition's corner for sure.
Yeah. Judy won't let you get away. Judy won't let you get away with
anything. Blake Choco. Oh, look at that shot. Glad I retired. Front face lock now. As Donna tags Judy back in. Double shot to the lower abdomen.
Nice double kick there. The lioness, though,
is not faring too well right at the moment.
No, she's not. Well, neither of them actually are living up to that promise, although they have made one or two really aggressive moves.
Well, they picked on the toughest competition right off the bat, Lord.
Yes, they did. Maybe that was their mistake.
These two right here certainly can give anyone a negative attitude.
Right.
Lioness into the ride. Whoa, what a crunching elbow.
Oh.
Comes right up with a kip up. And a single leg trip. Nice maneuver from behind.
Oh, good maneuvers from that Japanese girl.
Turns it loose. Had control and just threw it to the wind. Karate chop right underneath the chin. Another quick tag made as Chigusa steps in. And Judy Martin wound up, but no, reverses it. Look out. Whoa. Hello. Welcome to America.
Yes. Isn't she something, that Judy?
Oh.
The Japanese girls must know of her, though. She's well-traveled.
You can imagine being her husband and complaining about the soup not tasting too good or something like that.
Yes. Where's my clean shirt?
Nice double-team effort there as Donna stepped in, and Judy just dropped Chikuza's back right on the outstretched knee. Action, fast and furious here in the Boston Garden. Jam-packed, hanging off the rafters here with this World Wrestling Federation. Tremendous matchups. Oh, look, come on, Danny. Oh. Turn around, take a look. Chigusa's getting choked out over there in the corner. I would say, you know, if you packaged both of these teams together, these Japanese girls got to be outweighed by 100 pounds, Lord.
They look as if they're outweighed, but they haven't really been outmaneuvered. But the point is that right now, the experience of the American girls is showing very strongly in their favor.
Oh, nice single leg pick there, amateur move. Oh, Boston Crab, a half a one.
Single-legged Boston there, and that is a damaging hold. And Judy knows that, too.
Well, she came in a hurry to break that up because she knew that was curtains. What a more fitting place to put on the Boston Crab than here in the Boston Garden. Lioness wants to get into the action. Danny Davis saying no. In the meantime, being choked out. Chigusa Nagoyo. Right in front of all those international cameramen, Lord.
Yes, and I think Donna had a piece of the rope in her hands there too, if I'm not mistaken. They're not going to let these girls get away with anything, and I'm afraid they're taking advantage, and it's beginning to tell.
Donna knows every devious way to get to you, Lord.
Yeah, she's made a study of that, a lifetime practice, you might say.
My God. Oh, knee right to the top of the cranium, trying to make the tag.
I really think right now, Gorilla, that it's only the youthfulness of these girls that are keeping them in this match. And the conditioning.
Well, their hair is very short, but it's still a disadvantage as Donna keeps Chigusa from making the tag.
The Japanese girls are in just excellent condition.
Lioness wanting to get in there. Oh, 2 inches away from making the tag.
Judy can make them pay.
Oh, was that close? Only in horseshoes and hand grenades. Lord, as
who said
Mean
that?
Gene would say.
Yes. Okas.
Look at Judy now taunting the lioness.
Oh my word.
Punched her right in the eye.
Right in the eye. I wouldn't be surprised if that is going to swell up and mar her vision
Oh, Chigusa retaliating with some karate chops. There's a tag. Lioness steps in. Oh, she's hot. Judy going in for the ride. Look out.
Tremendous drop kick.
Really got up high. And a suplex coming up now.
No, slam.
Slam.
Yes. Slam.
Down for the cover.
She's not going to get Judy that way. But what a drop kick. What a drop kick. Another
hooked up
power
again
slam.
In a slam position. Oh, that's not a legal tag.
Whoa!
It's got to be on the outside to make a tag, Lord.
Well, the referee's not taking any notice of that. He's just let that go by.
Well, maybe he figures that's part of the Japanese rules. Oh, look at this.
Come on.
Twister turning it over into a crab. Submission hold.
Donna was
Judy's
coming in
good.
Then.
Yo, now she's all the way over. If she sits back, she could be in deep trouble here.
Judy's left ankle is bent right over there. I don't know if that can show
very
on the camera,
painful,
but just
submission
look at
hold. Donna trying to make her way in to save her partner. Excruciating pain. Look at the pressure being applied here by the Tiger. She settles. Lioness, I'm sorry. I
well,
said
the
tiger.
Lioness is outside. I think that's Chigusa inside. That's very cool to tell, isn't it?
Who's got the scorecard? Can't tell all the players without a scorecard.
Judy's made it to the ropes anyway.
Gonna
and
have
she's
to break
got
the
herself.
She's going to have trouble walking around, I'll tell you that.
Yes, that was a
quick
difficult
tag made now
situation.
In the number two team. Number two member comes in. High from the top turnbuckle.
Oh!
Quick move by Judy as she turned the tables immediately.
And
there's
look
that
at that
experience, Lord.
Right, and she doesn't let that get away from her. She's taking full advantage of that fact of that mistake they made.
Well, the Lioness thought that Judy was just about out of it, and she wasn't.
No.
Talk about deception. Look out. Oh, what a clothesline! She's watching for her partner to come
in. Oh, my word.
No tag made yet. That's an illegal maneuver. Danny Davis making a count. Look out.
Still
double team slingshot. Judy in.
Double karate. What is Davis doing?
I don't know.
He's sending her out now.
This is just a double team effort, a wild double team effort as they're dropping elbows one after the other one. That last one caught her right in a kisser. Going to work on
the Judy.
Excuse me.
Judy found that something extra and came back with a vengeance.
Double dropkick on Donna Cristinello.
Look out, slingshot.
Look out.
No.
Oh,
giant swing.
Giant swing by the Lioness.
My word. Look at
and her. Donna's going for a long ride. And a cover made. Hooks the leg. It's over.
Fantastic.
What an upset here in the Boston Gardens.
I don't believe it.
Tremendous victory by the Crush Girls. Let's get the official word.
The Crush Girls.
Look at Donna. She's still dizzy. Can't get to her feet. Referee Danny Davis.
She was on
raising the hand.
Judy doesn't believe it. Donna doesn't know what's happening. But those Japanese girls have kept their record intact. That's win number one here in the United States of America for them.
Tremendous ovation by this capacity crowd as they just love the Crush Girls. Let's go back and take a look at the big giant swing. Look at this.
Double drop kick.
You know, that was my patented finish, oh Lord, the giant swing.
Yes.
I don't think I ever went around this many times.
Look at this.
There's one, two,
going to the head.
Three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten, 11 revolutions.
There we go.
Donna doesn't know where. Oh, God. She didn't know whether she was in Boston or Chicago or Detroit or New Orleans or Osaka. Crush Girls on the victory. We'll be back. Talk about your tough competitors. You're looking at one right there, Jim the Anvil Neidhart. The Hart Foundation seen fit to split up in single competition.
And Neidhart being the powerhouse of that combination, and he's matched against a speedy youngster from England, Scott McGee, so this should be an interesting and exciting match.
A very disturbing thing, Lord, I just noticed.
Tell me.
Besides being hit with the timekeeper's hammer, the mouth of the South now has a new megaphone.
Oh, God, I can't stand it.
I thought the junkyard dog destroyed one. He certainly did. And what did the mouth do? He ran out and got a new one. Look at it.
Oh, gosh, I hope he doesn't come around here with that. I just hope he doesn't come around. He's a pest with that thing. Just an absolute pest.
Wow, Scotty McGee.
The powerhouse.
Scotty McGee doing the wrong thing, Lord.
Hey, look at this.
Oh, nice, beautiful underhook. But the powerhouse just too powerful. Whew.
Just a little bit too early in this match. If he'd have run him down a little bit longer, he may have held him there. But a two count is certainly going to make Neidhart think a lot more.
Come on, let's see how strong.
Oh, can you hear that? He's got an extra powerful unit. They can hear that in Providence, I think.
Oh, gosh, just listen to that thing.
What a distracting thing that has to be for Scotty McGee to have to listen to that. Look, he's looking right at it. How can you help look at that horrible looking thing speaking into that megaphone?
That's an extra powerful one he's got there. That's more powerful than the last one. I think he's got triple, quadruple A batteries in that. My gosh.
The anvil, oh, look at that, trying to take a chunk out of young Scotty. In for the ride, watch out. Sunset flip, he had the momentum going, took the big guy down. He couldn't, his legs wouldn't reach, Lord.
No, but he jumped so high and he was so fast. What's the speed of Scotty between the ropes?
He surprised the anvil for sure.
Yeah.
Little consultation here now.
You know, one thing I've noticed about Scott McGee, when he first started wrestling here in America, he was using that close contact that European wrestlers use, that style, but lately he's become a lot more open style with his wrestling, and I think he's doing a lot better with it.
Scotty off again, shoulder block, and the anvil didn't budge. Scotty said, I'm gonna try it again. Oh, look out! Scotty coming right out at us! Scotty McGee just crushed out here. Let me, if you put that thing down for a second, I'd like to ask you something.
Ask me anything
Let me ask you this, Jimmy. In this point in time, why are you splitting your men up into single competition?
Because only I know. You know, the greatest tag team today, you know, Captain Lou Albano, he's got the British Bulldogs.
Don't spit all over me, Jimmy. Just talk.
You want to know the question or not? What are you talking about, man?
Go ahead, answer the question.
I furnish towels with my showers. Let me tell you something right now. But everybody knows that Beefcake and Valentine were the world champions. But for some reason, Luscious Johnny won't give Jimmy Hart and the Hart Foundation a chance for those titles. We've got to get through the British Bulldogs.
Well, listen, only the championship committee can do that. You guys can't just say, I want a title shot. You have to earn it.
We'll earn it. We beat the Killer Bees. We beat Uncle Elmer. We beat Hillbilly Jim. What more do you want?
You have to be deemed number one. Take a powder. Let me have the batteries out of that thing.
Uh-huh.
Oh, my God. He's got a siren, Lord.
Oh, dear. What is that? God.
He's got a siren hooked up
somehow. Some sort of addendum on it. In the meantime, I don't know if you were watching very closely, but
I was watching.
He just dropped Scotty McGee on his throat on that barrier that runs around the outside of the ring, and that was a damaging hold, and I think, quite honestly, he should have been disqualified right there and then.
Well, maybe we'll get you a blue shirt next time and a black bow tie, and we'll have a guest referee appearance by his lordship. Love to see that. I would personally buy a ticket.
I can assure you I would be much worse than any referee you've ever seen. It's a thankless task they have to perform, and I'm afraid that sometimes we're apt to over-criticize them.
Well, the anvil now playing with Scotty McGee's mind as he's verbally taunting him. Look at this, double handful of hair. Come on, ref, do your job. Oh, I'd hate to be the referee, Lord, come April 7th in the Nassau Coliseum when Mr. Yeah. T puts on the boxing gloves and faces Rowdy Roddy Piper. They tell me that Piper's gone out and got Lou Duva to come and coach him in his corner.
And that should be fantastic because he's the Olympic Games boxing coach.
Yes, he is. But who did Mr. T go out and get? Smoking Joe Frazier.
Yes.
When I told Jesse the body that, Jesse said, I love that because Frazier, all he knows how to do is lead with his face. I can't wait till Joe hears that from the mouth of Jesse the body. Scotty outsmarted there, but now he's going to turn the tables. Oh, he got caught.
Almost.
Suplex coming up by the anvil. Oh, nice block. Look at how he grapevined that leg.
Good block by Scotty.
He has to pick himself up in order to be effective now. Can't do that. And blocked again. Oh,
Scotty.
He got the anvil. Tremendous power move.
Oh, what an effort by McGee to bring 280 pounds over his shoulder like that.
The mouth was speechless for a second there, Lord. Look at him. He doesn't know what to say.
Good mash out there to the chest and the face of
beautiful
Nighthawk.
European style uppercuts.
Yes.
There's another one. He might have took lessons from Les Thornton on how to throw those, Lord. Oh, reversal here. Wow, Scotty Harden. Scoops him up in midair like he weighs nothing. Power slam.
Oh!
Knocked the wind right out of him. It's over.
Good victory by Nighthawk. Good wrestling. Good timing. And a good show of power.
Talk about impressive victories. That was one right there. Let's get the official word. South, Jimmy Hart ecstatic over this victory here. Very impressive one by that man right there at the anvil. Let's go back and take a look at that power slam.
Just
want to call this, Lord.
Reversal. And the way that Nighthawk was looking, he was looking as if he was beaten, and now he turned him right round. Power all the way. A big power slam. There's nothing McGee can do about that.
You have
academic.
To have tremendous power to control somebody like that in midair, Lord, and the anvil certainly has that. On the victory right there, that mean-looking character. We'll be back.
Not again.
And he represents from Calgary, Canada, weighing 238 pounds, Bret the Hitman Hart. His opponent, soon to be approaching the ring from Honolulu, Hawaii,
Ricky, the Dragon Steamboat, where is he? There he comes. Big smile on his face. Acknowledgement to the many fans he has everywhere in the entire wrestling world.
And it would appear that 20,000 people plus here are to a man for Ricky Steamboat, the Black Dragon.
What a tremendous matchup this is going to be, Lord.
Oh, this is one I've looked forward to for a long time, since this match was first signed, when those contracts were inked in. I've looked forward to this because Bret Hart is the most improved wrestler of this year and of last year, obviously. And this could be his biggest test. In fact, I think it is, don't you?
Oh, no question about that.
I couldn't hear it either way. I couldn't hear it the whole.
Oh, look at that! The Hitman not wasting any time. Didn't give the Dragon a chance to get his wrestling gear off. Pearl Harbor job. I guess he figures he needs a little edge, Lord.
Well, I think Jimmy Hart told him. He pushed him out. He said, go get him, and that's exactly what Bret is doing.
You snake. What do you...
Like that. Never give a second even break, baby. Look at him. Never give a second even break, baby. Look,
you're going to have to pay for that, Jimmy Hart.
We'll never pay for it, baby. We don't need the music. We don't need anybody but the Hart Foundation, baby. Look at the Dragon. He don't look too bad now. He's not breathing fire now, is he, baby?
Never saw the Dragon short.
Well, that was it. I said that that's what Hart did. He
look
gave him the go.
Reversal!
Just a tremendous
power into the turnbuckle. Knocked him right into the middle of next week.
Just tremendous force there, Gorilla. The way he came
in. For
the
Dragon to get things going, Lord. At least get that karate jacket off.
Uh-huh. Oh, so deliberate. The Dragon is looking really deliberate. Look at the look on his face. Look at the Dragon.
Would not want to be in a Hitman's shoes right now. Wow!
Oh!
Karate chop right between the eyes. A Hitman down. Dragon at a disadvantage. He's got to keep an eye on the mouth of the south all the time, too.
Well, the Dragon's weathered that first attack, and he's come out on top. But sometimes, you know, that can pay later on in a match. And if Bret Hart can keep his attack
going after him.
If Bret Hart can keep his attack going, we may see that payoff later on.
Well, the Dragon's got to be careful not to be distracted by the mouth of the south, because it doesn't take long for the Hitman to do a number on you when your back is turned. Armbar now by the Dragon, Ricky Steamboat.
A wise choice, because at that particular time, Hart was looking as if he was going to be able to weather it, but wear him down now. And then attack him more strongly later on.
Well, it's a wise hold, in my opinion, Lord, because he can hold on to it and keep an eye on the mouth at the same
yes,
time.
Yes, that's true. Also, a double-edged sword, in other words.
Yes. The Pasadena crowd here in the Boston Garden was stunned by that Pearl Harbor attack.
I think we all were, not only Ricky Steamboat, but I think you and I were both stunned, absolutely, Gorilla, there.
Well, the Dragon has always been very astute when it comes to being ready for a match and knowing who to watch out for. But when you've got the mouth of the south in there, the distracting, horrid thing that he is, well, you can easily become distracted.
You have to hand it to the mouth of the south, though, because before he took Bret Hart under his wing, you might say, or into his guidance, Bret Hart was just an ordinary young wrestler coming in, but look what he's done.
Oh, that power move! Talk about doing damage to the wrist and elbow joints. That one will put you out of commission for a long time. You either go or your arm breaks, Lord.
That's absolutely true. Unfortunately for Bret, he went. Unfortunately for Bret, he was caught.
A hammerlock and a tight waist, and now he's let the tight waist go, but still got that hammerlock, and rams his shoulder right into the top turnbuckle. Well, it looks to me like the Dragon has decided he's going to go to work on that left arm and shoulder for all it's worth.
That is his game plan, I would imagine, Gorilla, and nobody comes in without a game plan. They all have something in mind.
The Hitman, most impressive. Oh, look at that nice move stuck between the legs. And one
twice
more time. And off the ropes. swung around hard in. Oh, what an elbow!
Hart didn't know where he was going, coming, or he couldn't see the Dragon half the time, but he sure finished up on the wrong end of that move.
The Dragon, obviously the upper hand as far as speed is concerned in this matchup, but not a whole lot.
Good tactician, too.
Look at that horrid individual, that despicable human being.
Sometimes I wonder if it's destruction for his own man as well, Gorilla.
Sometimes it is.
I'm sure it is on occasions.
And the headband manages to make his to his feet now, and unloads with the right hand and made the Dragon break the hold. Bret Hart does everything with such tremendous effectiveness. He hurts you with every move he makes.
Absolutely.
Hard and nice leapfrog by the Dragon. And another one. And a back. Oh, nice block. He tried for a hip block. And now he reaches over, hooks the leg. Now he's got it. Unfortunately, the hitman couldn't think of the counter quick enough.
Well, he counted him twice in a row there, but Steamboat came back with something even better.
Your man is not faring
you
too well.
You just saw what he did.
Are you horse?
No,
I hope.
Not a horse. He just pulled the guy's tights. He just pulled the hitman's tights. He pulled him by the hair. He's used karate. He's used every legal movement.
Every legal movement. Yes,
illegal.
Every
illegal.
No, you said
You're
legal, Jimmy.
Upset.
Yes.
I'm going to have a nervous breakdown before
take
this
a hike.
Over
will you please take a hike? Get out. Get that megamouth out of here.
I don't know how you can speak to him, Gorilla. I just can't bring myself to speak to him at all.
Well, he was so frustrated. He said that the Dragon has done every legal move to his man, and he certainly
yes, he did. That's exactly what he said.
You sounded know, so, like he was getting hoarse. I hope he is.
I sincerely hope so. This match that started off at that fast and furious pace is still holding that pace, and unfortunately for Bret, he hasn't been able to take advantage of that initial attack that he made on Steamboat, which was so successful.
Dragon having some running commentary here with the mouth of the South could be a big mistake. Can't let that guy get to you. It'll cost you the match. In the meantime, he's put an awful lot of punishment on the left arm and shoulder to Hitman, who's trying to get out with some right hands. Not a whole lot behind. It took three of them to break the hold. Uh-oh, look out. Atomic drop. Oh, oh nice backflip. Oh. Oh! What a reverse crescent Ooh. Kick right in the forehead by the Dragon. The hitman doesn't know exactly where he is. Oh, look at that.
Oh, twisted him.
Reverse neck breaker beautifully applied by the hitman as the Dragon made a cardinal mistake in dropping the head.
Yes, and wasn't that a good move by the hitman, because he twisted the entire body of the Dragon. Now the Dragon's really paying for that. These two men are so well conditioned, though, they can swing the tables at any time. Just look at Hart. You wouldn't know that he'd taken all that punishment he just previously took. He's looking so commanding now.
Oh, headbutt, one of his favorite maneuvers. Dragon now feeling the wrath of the hitman. Come on, referee. Well, that was legal. Right into the lower abdomen area.
As you said before, Gorilla, everything the hitman does to you hurts.
Dragon in for the ride. Wow, caught one again. Oh, right outside and out of sight. Face first. Down onto the hardwood floor. Here in the Boston Garden, the Dragon is down there. How bad he's hurt, we can't tell yet. We'll get our number seven camera around there to take a good shot. There he is. He's on his feet. Talk about resiliency. Talk about your guts. A lesser man would have been on his way to the locker room.
Quite a few minutes to go, definitely. Both these men have taken such tremendous punishment, and it's only conditioning that's keeping either of them in this match.
Hitman unloading with some big roundhouse rights. Right on a kisser to Dragon, who's got to be reeling right now. Suplex going to bring him in the hard way.
Stood him up.
Oh, beautifully executed. Over for the cover. We could have a three count here. Oh, two and three quarters.
And once again, Bret Hart gave that twist. Did you notice that, Gorilla? As he put the suplex on him, and that really hurts.
Bret Hart complaining vehemently to the referee, but the referee was right there, and it was 2 3/4. Chant going out from this capacity crowd, Steamboat.
I think they're intent on drowning out the mouth of the South with that dreaded megaphone there. I wanted to say something else, but I guess I shouldn't say that.
I guess you shouldn't, Lord.
No.
Dragon trying to come out with some kidney shots, and the Hitman retaliated.
Slam, scoop,
up. Oh, couldn't hold it.
Couldn't hold it.
2 1/2 that time.
Steamboat is just hanging in there at the moment by the skin of his teeth, and I'm afraid he is looking very much the worse for wear now.
Really dazed, looking around, couldn't quite find his opponent there for a moment. Oh, look at this. Oh, went for a backbreaker. Nice backflip by the Dragon. And the Dragon manages to slam him, but he's really still hurt hard.
Yes, it's taken his toll, that physical punishment that he's already endured. But look at Hart. I don't think he knows where he is now. In fact, Hart's very slow to move.
Dragon. Look out. Oh! Hitman brought those knees up at the last second and did further damage to the lower abdomen of the already hurt Dragon.
I've seldom seen the Dragon make two mistakes in a row, but he's done that twice now. And he's in trouble once again.
Well, when you're dazed, Lord, you're in a knockdown, drag-out affair. You got a guy outside the ring with a horrible megaphone distracting you. Anything and everything is possible.
Absolutely.
In the
out
realm.
He goes.
Uh-oh. Out onto the floor again. Not the place to be. The Hitman going right out after him. Dragon managed to hang onto that bottom rope to keep from going.
Look out. On the concrete floor there.
Oh, slam hard onto the wooden floor. Ooh. Covering the ice here in the Boston Garden. Big congratulations there. The match is not over yet, Mouth.
Steamboat down and not showing a great deal of recovery either. The signs are at the moment that he's absolutely exhausted and he must have been hurt.
Hitman jumped into the ring immediately to break the count before both men were counted out. And now a single count going out on a Dragon who manages to sneak in underneath that bottom rope. And a Hitman right there waiting for him. Power slam.
Just look at this coming. A running power slam.
Shoulder breaker. Yes, power slam. Whoa!
Oh. Whew. Steamboat didn't kick out of that. He just lifted one shoulder.
Oh, the Mouth of the South is hot. He's pounding on the apron.
Steamboat didn't have the energy to kick hard off.
He couldn't kick out. He had all to do to pick up that left shoulder. And the Hitman is looking very impressive.
He is, and he's looking stronger every moment, too. I'm really surprised.
Another backbreaker, yes.
And this time, no escape by Steamboat. Last time he was able to reverse it.
That's it.
Will he go away with that blessed thing?
Reeking in pain here as the Hitman goes to the second turnbuckle on the inside. Oh, big elbow, but the Dragon was already gone. Why did that hurt?
That's the first mistake Hart has made. Could that be the little crack in his armor? Could that be the weakness that Steamboat's been looking for?
Big karate shot by the Steamer, and another one. But there isn't that full impact behind those blows like there usually are.
No, he hasn't floored him with either one of those
yet. Hitman floored him. That one nailed him pretty good.
Now he's floored
him. Dragon crawling over to make the cover. One, two, oh.
Close.
So close and yet so far.
Now Hart is dragging. Hart is dragging a little bit now. Up. Drop it.
Oh, suplex took the starch out of both men. Look at the Dragon. Just rolling over, barely managing the cover. Two. Whoa. And the Hitman gets that shoulder up.
I think the Hitman is playing with fire there because he's trying to get a bit more energy for a little bit more respect. But he's going to lose this match if he does that.
He's almost knocked unconscious right now. Wow, that won't help him either.
He's got the leg.
Oh, hooks the leg, two count only.
That time Hart moved before that three count was coming down.
Showing me a lot of guts, Lord. The hitman got tremendous amount of resiliency.
It's conditioning with these youngsters, Gorilla. Their conditioning is absolutely unbelievable.
Dragon upset now, shoves the referee. You can't do that, you gotta be careful.
Very careful.
Referee realizing that he's in the corner, he's trying to get him out of there. You gotta give the guy a chance to get out into the ring area. Hitman gonna go for the ride. No, reversal, and a double reversal. Oh, and Dragon got thrown right into the referee. And now a nice close-up for the cover. There's no one there to cover.
Carlos got him down.
Look at the hip, look at the mouth. Look, he's upset.
That is a moral victory for Hart, I would say. He clotheslined him perfectly there and had him covered for about 10 possibly. In again. Another reversal.
Reversal again. Ducks underneath the chop. And another beautiful shot. Oh, and what's that? Take him over. He got it.
Oh, what a surprise there by Steamboat. Just when I thought he'd lost absolutely everything.
Look at the mouth of the South. He is really bent out of shape. Tremendous action here in the Boston Garden. Let's go forget the official word.
The winner of this match, Ricky the Dragon Steamboat.
Well, I think the mouth of the South has got a valid point there.
He certainly does. A hitman doesn't have to feel bad about that loss. A referee knocked out of commission when the hitman had the Dragon reeling and wasn't able to count. Nowhere in sight to make the count. A lucky night in the Boston Gardens for that man right there, Ricky the Dragon Steamboat. Let's go back and take a look, Lord.
A double reverse. Hit that referee. Down goes the referee, but watch this. Now, here was the crucial point. There, look at that. Right down on the back of his head, and there's no way Steamboat's going to kick out.
Two, three, four, five, six, seven. A seven count. The Dragon still hadn't made an attempt to kick out.
And he was still unfortunate here because Hart had an excess of energy, and yet look what happened. Here he goes into the ropes. That reverse. Now watch this.
Watch the momentum take him over here.
Boom.
Over. Nice roll up, hooks the leg, very nicely gets a three count. Wow. Well, anything and everything can happen in the realm of professional wrestling, and it did right here in the Boston Garden. There's your winner right there.
This match is one fall with a 1 hour time limit for the Intercontinental Heavyweight Championship. First, the challenger from Tecula, Mexico, 244 pounds, Tito Santana. And a champion from Sarasota, Florida, 239 pounds, Randy the Macho Man Savage. And he is accompanied by Elizabeth.
She looks lovely, Lord.
She certainly does. I've long been an admirer of Elizabeth. And look at Savage. He looks lovely,
right
too.
Here in the Boston Garden that the Macho Man stole the title away from Tito Santana.
And Santana is on fire already. Obviously, he remembers that.
Santana trying to get the champion inside the ring, and believe me, that's what it takes. Carlo can only change hands on a submission or a pinfall. Countouts do not count.
No. But Santana is definitely dedicated to getting this title back again.
You gotta get in the ring, Savage.
You told me not
You got to get inside there. You can't. You can't defend it out here. Get your body up into the ring. That's where you got to be.
I don't think he's all that anxious to get in there.
Because they love me, and they realize that I'm the best that's ever been in a squared circle, and somebody better tell him that.
Well, he's pretty good inside the square circle, but I would debate the point about him being the best ever.
I couldn't hear what he said, Lord.
Well, he said he was the best ever in the squared circle.
Well, he's telling a lie.
I'd have to argue on that one particular point.
He's certainly trying to do a little psych job here on the former champion, Tito Santana. You got to get up into the ring, fella.
He's going to wait until the fire in Santana burns out, and I don't think that's ever going to happen.
Highly unlikely. This is what a setting this is. What a beautiful opportunity for the former champion to get the title back right in the place where he lost it.
Absolutely, and I'll tell you something else. If Savage is not careful, he's going to psych himself out of this match.
Well, it's very, very possible.
He's taking his ring
attire off out here on the floor, which may be a safe thing to do. Showing the belt to the fans here in the Boston Garden, but you got to defend that belt. And in order to do that, you got to get up into the ring.
Don't dare me, baby.
What do you say, don't dare me?
I really don't know. But I must say one thing for Savage. When he comes into the ring, he is in 100% physical condition. He is a credit, really, to the wrestling profession, the way he trains himself and the way he dedicates himself to his chosen career.
There's the bell. We're underway now. Oh, look at Santana. And right out the other end goes the Macho Man. Wow, was he quick.
And he didn't burn any fires out in Santana with all that psyching going on around the ringside and not getting in. Savage back on the outside again. Elizabeth trying to do something to help his morale, I think.
Right out again quickly. Yeah. Macho Man not wanting to tangle right now. Oh, don't do that, Tito. The chance will go right out the window in a hurry.
Yes. Very, very quickly. Tito's been waiting for this match for a long, long time. He's just been hungry to get his title back. This is his opportunity, and I don't think he's going to blow it anyway. In fact, he's standing right inside the ring now, waiting for Savage to come back in.
Macho Man vaulting out again. Uh-oh. Oh, look at this. Santana going right out after him. As the race begins, who's the quicker?
Both out.
Macho Man around the corner in a hurry. Oh, he's got caught.
He's got him.
Santana nails him. Pulls him down right in front of us here. The action hot and heavy.
He's got the boss into the barrier.
Wow, right out into the ringside area.
Santana in quickly and out
Santana
again.
Santana pulling out all the stops here in the Boston Garden. Look out. He wants it back inside the ring. That's the only place he can get that title back. Elizabeth, very concerned look on her face. As Tito Santana is a house of fire. Look at Elizabeth. She is really concerned, Lord.
And well, she might be, because right now, all the impetus is with Santana. Everything going his way.
The champion is out again.
And it looks like if Santana's going to go out, then I should say Savage is going to go out. Santana's going to throw him back in again.
Danny Davis being jerked around and they're laying the count now on both men. I'm sure that Tito's going to get him back inside there. He knows what the rules are all about. Lord.
Right, and there's 20,000 people here on their feet urging Santana. They want him to get this belt back.
Uh-oh, Tito now going to work on the left leg of the Macho Man. Possibly to set him up for that patented figure four leg lock of his. Danny Davis trying to make a break. He's got to break the hold. The Macho Man had a hold of the ropes.
Yes.
Oh, Santana walked right into that right hand. Nice leverage move by the champion as he hooked the former champion's tights and vaulted him right outside the ring.
And that is one of his favorite tricks that Savage does, and he does it so well. Right when Santana thought he had him where he wanted, Savage can turn those tables. And
now it's the former champion who's out on the floor. Tremendous move here by the champion. Uh-oh, sneaking around the corner, trying to come from the blind side of Santana, and does. Double axe handle right to the cervical vertebrae area. And the champion, realizing the count is going on, hustles back inside the ring.
Santana hurt twice there, once to the back where he had the blow from Savage, and once when his stomach went into the iron bar that forms the apron of that ring.
Danny Davis certainly with his work cut out for him here in this championship match here this week in the World Wrestling Federation. Intercontinental title on the line. Oh, look at that raking up. He learned that from the body, I think, though. The body has been advising him. You know, they are tag team partners.
Yes, they're very close friends as well.
That's one of the body's favorite moves. Look out, bounce away. He caught him. Santana almost got around to nail him with a right, but didn't make it. It could
but
be over right
here. Hooked the leg.
Hooks both legs. Yeah. And still, Tito able to kick out. Danny Davis telling the Savage, I'll do the counting, you do the wrestling.
I see that Santana is favoring that right knee where he had the operation. I wonder if that's hurting him at all.
Over for the cover again, hooks a leg, two count only. As Tito forces that left arm up between the bodies. Macho Man in control of this matchup right now.
It took the Macho Man 10 minutes to get into this position with Santana. And now that he's there, he's not going to give up. Oh, good clothesline by Savage. Absolutely floored Santana across him.
Whoa, was that close?
Oh, I think Santana was a little dizzy there because he didn't have the leg hooked and he only barely escaped from that.
Oh, now rams him backwards right into those turnbuckles. Champion now standing on the second turnbuckle on the inside, pounding away at the face of Tito Santana. Oh, look at this atomic drop, he caught it. And this crowd erupts. What a tremendous opportunity.
When Santana needs something, he seems to be able to dig down into the bag and bring out a surprise. Look at that, once again.
Right underneath the sternum. Santana fortunate enough to have the foresight to make sure that a return match was written into the contract on all title matches.
I really think that's the way it should be.
Absolutely.
Santana a lot more confidence back now since he managed to put that reverse atomic drop on Savage.
Champion now backpedaling, asking for mercy here. Hard in, look out, flying forward. Oh! He nailed him with it. We could have it. No.
What happened now? I wasn't sure.
Santana let the cover go, wanted to drop another elbow. Two count only as the champion kicks out.
Now
he's going for that figure four. He wants to beat him with it. Macho Man manages to get out. What's he doing now, Lord? He's back into his tights again for possibly another foreign object. But Santana caught him. Throws him back into the ring and knock it. Look at the champion crawling like a coward, trying to escape. But Santana catches up to him.
Santana's not letting him go escape. And he's going to make it a lot more difficult and a lot more tougher than Savage has possibly hoped for.
Danny Davis trying to tell Tito Santana that you got to let the guy get back into the ring on his own. He's outside there. He gets a count to get back in. Danny pulling away. Oh, look at this.
Oh, he shouldn't have
done that. Danny Davis just hurled across the ring by Tito Santana.
He should never have done that.
You can't do that.
Oh, my word.
You cannot do that.
Oh, that Latin temperament got the better of Santana there, and he threw everything away.
Tito Santana lost his cool, Lord, and he lost this match as well.
Oh, he lost everything there, and I don't know if any return clauses are going to be included in a contract after that.
Let's get the official word. To regain the Intercontinental Heavyweight Championship, Tito Santana threw everything to the wind, including the referee Danny Davis. It cost him the title. Let's go back and take a look, Lord.
Santana was right on top there, not going to let Savage get out. I'm afraid he's beginning to lose his temper now. He's coming close to disqualification because he didn't let go of that hold. The referee's going to make sure he does to give him another chance, and that is it.
Wow.
That is goodbye.
Well, goodbye title shot, and also goodbye some money out of the pocketbook, because you can't do that without getting fined severely. Tito Santana losing his cool here in a Boston Garden in his attempt to regain the title. Holy mackerel, we'll be back. Wild action here in the Boston Garden as we take a look at the Devils duo, Devils of Japan.
I've never seen anything like that, two young ladies like that before, Gorilla. In fact, I'm wondering if this thing with the armor on is a lady or is a man. But the announcement is that she is a Japanese lady, so I would presume that underneath all that armor is a Japanese lady.
Wow. Well, look at the bewildered look on the face of Velvet McIntyre as these two begin to take off their ring attire, which may take a considerable amount of time.
I would imagine that takes a considerable amount of power and energy and strength to carry all that stuff around. Mind you, that is a big girl. That is a big lady underneath all that. Just look at the size of her. I think that's the one who weighed 210 pounds, was it not? Ooh, that is a big ugly lady. Not just a big lady, a big ugly lady.
Well, this one's underway. I've been in Japan many times and seen a lot of beautiful Japanese girls, and neither one of these girls resembles that remark.
No, they're not those petite little girls who wear those kimonos and arrange flowers. Little tiny coffee cups.
You know, Lord, right here at this particular point in time, I want to give my condolences to the body, because he's missing this, and he wouldn't want to miss this for the world.
I don't think so. Their haircuts are similar to the body. I think he'd be one with them, with their hair designers, or whatever you would call them. Hairdressers, I can't imagine, but designers, yes.
I believe that it's Bull Naino who's in there now with Velvet McIntyre. And the bull looks like she didn't miss too many meals, Lord.
No. And the other one has Dump written on her
boots.
Well,
that's her name, Dump Matsumoto.
Dump?
Yes.
What's all of a dump?
I don't know. I think whatever dump you have, whatever you can attribute it to, go ahead and do it.
Well, somebody dumped her right here in the ring, and I'm just waiting to see her. They are awesome, though, aren't they, Gorilla? They are absolutely awesome.
Well, they'll get an education from Velvet McIntyre, who, for the first time since I've seen her, is in the ring now without any foot attire on.
I wonder why, because I think that's just I'm going to say a silly thing to do, but
well,
I just can't see.
Might not be too silly, but either she wants to get some additional foot speed or she forgot her boots.
Right.
One or two.
But we have seen with some of those Samoans who don't wear foot attire that they can suck to the mat with the soles of their feet, and it seems to be very difficult to knock them off their feet.
There's a tag made now. Don
like
Marie in there. I know one time, Lord, I made a trip over to Japan. Well, I made several dozen trips to Japan, but at one point I got over there and opened my bag and it was two right shoes.
Oh, God.
Handful of hair.
Oh,
No tag made there. No tag was made. Come on, refs, give me a break. There was no tag made there. And now we've got dumped Matsumoto in there.
I think there's something wrong with dumped Matsumoto.
Obviously, 220 pounds plus of fighting fury from Japan.
She is certainly no sylph-like figure.
Couldn't stay away from the rice bowl.
She has a lot of aggression, a lot of size, a lot of strength, but does she have durability?
Well, she absorbed those shots and now gives a karate shot of her own to Domery, who makes another quick tag. And Velvet's going to step in again. It must be some kind of a Japanese salute she's giving.
How about the hair, Gorilla? She's got a red stripe, a green stripe, and blonde. Ooh!
1 foot dropkick, she brushed it off. Didn't hit the mark. She's having a good time. Not going to win any beauty contests, that's for sure.
I wonder what the vital statistics are. 56, 56, 56, by the look of it.
Oh, handful of hair with an arm whip over and another one coming up.
Gosh.
One disadvantage that the American girl wrestlers have is that they have that long hair, some of them. Arm whip in, look. Freight train job.
Velvet McIntyre made a mistake running into her
as
like that.
Just dumped Velvet.
Oh, did she ever?
Velvet's got to stay on her feet, because if the dump falls on her, it'll be all over.
Oh, gosh.
They call themselves the Devils of Japan. I don't know, the Tons of Fun may have been more fitting.
Really? I wish I could understand Japanese, because they're shouting at each other in Japanese. I'd love to know what they're saying.
Double team effort now as the bull is in there. And just close off, taking a chunk right out of the forehead of Velvet McIntyre, Bull Naino. Boy, this team doesn't pay attention to the rules at all, Mark.
And neither of them do. Look at the pieces of hair that are just floating around the ring that are coming out of Velvet McIntyre's head.
They expect to be successful here on this tour of the United States. They're going to have to adhere to the American rules a little bit better.
I can see these two.
Because this referee's a little bit liberal, but we got some of them. That this match would have been over a long time ago. Nice duck underneath by Velvet. A leapfrog over the top.
Just made it.
A high crossbody. And the bull goes down 2 count only. Wow, the dump just screamed into my ear from the turnbuckle. Matsumoto was bent out of shape there. She let out some kind of a horrendous bonsai cry. It was just...
And I'm afraid that
Velvet... curdled milk.
Yes.
Sure.
Velvet has been feeling the wrath of the other member of this Japanese Devils duo. And not faring too well either.
They certainly are different.
She can't wait to get Donna in there.
Donna Marie now. Look at this job. Wow, right down on the exposed toe. Who knows what's inside those boots? Besides a big fat foot.
God.
Oh, look at that. Walking right on the throat.
Well.
Oh, standing right up on top of Donna Marie. Feeling the wrath of the Devils of Japan. Don't sell us American teams, Mark.
Wow. But they haven't been able to mount up any sort of defense against these two Japanese girls at the moment. I'm afraid the American girls are really on the receiving end of a lot of punishment here.
Well, Don Marie, not too much experience as far as tag team competition is concerned. Velvet McIntyre, of course, we know what her credentials are. We definitely know what these Japanese Devils are capable of doing.
Well, Velvet McIntyre one time did have part ownership of the Women's Tag Team Championship.
Look at that, splash job, and Maria manages to get out. Squeezed out of there somehow.
But only just. Is that the dump that's in there, or what? Which one is that that's in there,
The dump
Gorilla?
Is in there now. Dump Matsumoto. And she's dumping right now on Don Marie.
She really is. I've never seen Japanese girls like this before.
Uh-oh,
I must
like
say
some
that.
Kind of a foreign object. She reached into her ring attire to get it.
I believe the dump was the one that had all that armor on, didn't she?
I don't know.
Yeah, one of them had the arm.
I refuse to answer on the grounds that may tend to incriminate me. Don Moran for the win. Whoa, what a clothesline job. And the dump smells victory. Tag was made, though. Here comes Velvet. Look out, coming right at you, Lord. Elbow, just sort of stunned her. One-foot drop kick didn't do any harm. And Velvet now trapped. Comes out with eyes on her face. And a kick out quickly by the Bull.
Well, that was the first good move made by the Americans.
Beautiful elbow by Velvet McIntyre. As she's changed the tide here.
And she's beginning to get the measure of these two strange Japanese girls.
The Bull just ran over like a freight train. Velvet now whipped in hard. Look out.
Gosh.
Oh, another chill-curdling cry from the turnbuckle by the dump.
I'm pleased you're sitting there and I'm here. Look out.
Oh, Velvet sitting up on top of the shoulders. Forward roll could get a pinfall there.
Hold on.
Hooks the legs. One, two. Yes, she got her. The Bull got trapped by Velvet McIntyre with that beautiful front roll with a hookup. Let's get the official word.
The winners of this match, the team of Velvet McIntyre.
Hard-fought victory as Velvet is still down on the canvas, but she taught the ones from across the pond a lesson right here in the Boston Garden. They expected a victory here. They didn't get it. Let's go back and take a look at Velvet at work.
Velvet struggled hard to get in that position, but once she got into it, she knew exactly what to do. Hook those legs, shoulders down, one, two, and three.
Well, the tremendous weight of that team was used to defeat him, Lord.
Yes.
Velvet McIntyre, Don Marie on the victory here in the Boston Garden. We'll be back.
This bout is one fall with a 30-minute time limit. First from Hamilton, Ontario, Canada, weighing in at 273 pounds, Iron Mike Sharp.
Canada's greatest athlete. Hey!
His opponent making his way to the ring from Fort Bragg, North Carolina, 261 pounds, Corporal Kirshner.
Boston Garden erupting here as the Stars and Stripes being brought out by that man right there, Corporal Kirshner. Full of enthusiasm.
Oh, is he ever? He is so hyped up for this particular match. I don't think he could get any higher, no matter what he did. Just look at that face. Full of intensity.
That adrenaline is flowing in his veins 24 hours a day, I guarantee you.
Yes. He is ready.
Then for a rough week this year in the World Wrestling Federation, a rough week for him. Iron Mike Sharp, self-proclaimed Canada's greatest athlete.
Mr. Perpetual Motion. Nobody has ever slowed him down. They may have beaten him, but they've never trounced him or thrashed him.
Never loses a bit of enthusiasm, always in top-notch condition. His eagerness may be his biggest fault, Lord.
Yes, that's a possibility. I think that it's...
Oh! I don't know why the instructions, the bell had already rung.
The eagerness is there that you talked about, Gorilla. Look at him now. Doesn't stop.
Unloading with a vengeance. Iron Mike Sharp. Uh-oh, reversal here. Corporal coming up. Look at this. Monkey flip coming up out of the corner. Yes. Drop kick right in the back as Sharp was trying to turn away from it. And another one catches him on his side. And a third one sends a big guy down and out. Whoa, went right out of sight.
Oh, look at him, he's destroying
knocked over
everything.
The barricade.
270 pounds of absolute uncontrollable false power and energy. Look at
wow.
Him. Everything's gone there. He'll smash everything that gets
he's
in his
way. Which way to the shower? He's staggering.
Look out, police corps.
He doesn't know where he is.
Oh, my word. Oh, nothing can stop Big Iron Mike. This way, that way, backwards or forwards.
Talk about action and excitement here in the Boston Garden. It's personified whenever the World Wrestling Federation decides to invade Beantown.
Absolutely. Three great drop kicks by Carson with those huge combat boots. Put Mike out the ring, and he nearly put the ring and the whole stadium out of action anyway.
Lord, everyone buzzing about WrestleMania 2 coming down Monday, April 7, the greatest wrestling extravaganza of all time. I want to talk a little bit at this point in time about the big steel cage match coming up. King Kong Bundy steps into the steel cage with the world's champion Hulk Hogan. I think, to my recollection, the first time in the history of professional wrestling championship on the line in a steel cage.
Absolutely. I don't know whether it's the first time or not, but I can tell you something else about that. It is a specially reinforced steel cage because of the size of both of these men.
Well,
the tremendous poundage.
I thought, Lord, that Bobby the Brain Heenan had outsmarted himself a little bit, being that once you step into the steel cage, his man is at a disadvantage. Bundy only has one way to get out. I don't believe Bundy can get out over the top.
No, I don't know, but they were afraid that Bundy might take the whole steel cage out with him when they decided to make it with a much heavier gauge steel wire.
Well, that's only one of the biggest super extravaganza matches in WrestleMania 2. That one will take place in the Los Angeles Sports Arena. Uh-oh, look out. Iron Mike off with a shoulder block. I can't wait for April 7th. And another one sends a corporal down. Corp drops down in front, Mike over the top. Watch, leapfrog. Oh, drop kick. Didn't quite make it.
Oh, Mike is something else, is he?
Oh,
no.
God, like a bull in a china closet.
Oh, can you imagine him in a china shop?
Batten down the hatches. Iron Mike's in town. Corporal getting the okay from 20,000 plus here in the Garden. So go ahead and do it. Well, what are you waiting for, Cole? Do it.
I think he's...
Oh, he didn't want to do it.
No. I think he had Iron Mike off the hook there.
He sure
he
did. Had him trapped like a rat and let him escape.
But I don't think he would have hurt Iron Mike anyway. He could have put that big combat boot right into his face, and Iron Mike is Iron Mike. There's only one of him. He's one off.
Thank God. Wait a minute. He wants to talk about something.
He may not be replete with all the skills, but he certainly has the heart.
He wants to test his strength here for a professional. The crowd getting on his case. He doesn't like that. You got to give credit where credit is due. If everyone spent as much time on taking care of their body as that guy does, Iron Mike Sharp, believe me, there would be at least 20 million more Americans reaching past the age of 65.
Yes, definitely. Look at him, he's just all raw strength, isn't he? Raw and brute strength. He doesn't give a thought to skills any time at all, does he?
You know who he reminds me of? Lord Fred Atkins.
Yes.
Remember,
yes.
Fred Atkins?
I do
a
indeed.
Name out of the past. Oh,
what a gnarled old, dreadful person he is.
Yes, he could give you a negative attitude forever. Iron Mike still in control.
He could be Canada's finest athlete. That's quite on the cards.
Well, I'm sure that Wayne Gretzky and a lot of other guys would have something to say about that.
Oh,
look at this. Putting the boots to him now. Watch out, fingers. A cleanliness freak as well. Suplex coming up.
Look at that suplex. Just rammed him right in.
Might get a three count here. No, foot's underneath the bottom rope. In fact, one night right here in the Boston Garden, Lord, Iron Mike was on the third match. And when they closed the building up and locked it up, he was still in the shower. They locked him right in. He was here overnight.
Probably working out all night long,
said the
too.
Cheapest night's rent he ever had.
Look,
he doesn't know which corner to go to.
Oh,
leapfrog by the corporal.
Oh.
Clothesline.
Oh, my God. Oh.
Something had to give there.
Oh. What did you say about negative attitudes a little while ago?
Yeah.
I think he's given the call Corporal one there.
Corporal wishing he was back in Fort Bragg in the canteen with the boys as he just ran into that beautiful clothesline.
Boom. Oh. God. The corporal showing a lot of resilience to put up to that blastering attack there.
Boy, he's unloading with the heavy artillery. Going to drop off the apron now, just close line.
Corporal definitely looking the worst for wear now. He's in there feeling the wrath of Iron Mike.
Corporal with a very impressive win record here in the World Wrestling Federation. That could be in jeopardy here as the chant goes out from this capacity crowd, USA. Mike doesn't like it. He's saying, oh, Canada would settle him down a little bit, though.
I don't know, but look at Mike, he's sure.
There goes the corporal. And Iron Mike right out after him.
Look at Mike.
Right through the barricade.
Just look at him. He really doesn't care.
Well, they've each had a taste of that barricade now. We'll see what kind of recuperative powers that man has right there. Corporal Kirshner, he's having trouble just finding his way out of the barricade. Referee admonishing Iron Mike, but this referee doesn't command too much respect, I don't think.
If it moves, Mike will kick it. If it doesn't move, he'll jump on it. God,
wow, just
look
rammed
at
him face first right into the ring apron.
You've got to hand it to Kirchner. He's taken some punishment, and he shows a very stout heart.
Well, and now he's just trying to find some way to get back into the ring. Look out. Oh.
Nothing by half measures with Mike, huh?
Right to the sternum area. Makes it tough to breathe.
Now, pull him over, stretch his neck back over the top rope, and just let fire
Mike
with that
Mike is
big
telling the referee, Lord, get him back in here.
Yes.
Or I can beat on him some more. Snap measures the corporal back in. What's he going to do with him now? Oh.
Just look at him.
Corporal taking a tremendous beating here at the hands of the self-proclaimed Canada's number one athlete. If he just pay attention to what he's supposed to be doing out there and not worry about the crowd, he could get a very, very big upset here.
There's a big win.
Corporal in for the ride, ducks underneath the big right hand. High cross body, down on top, hooks the leg, 1-2 now. Big guy kicked out.
Powers out of that one. Look at him.
Corporal sending him in again for the ride. And a clothesline sends the well-conditioned athlete down to the can. He's begging for mercy, Lord.
Look at this.
Small package. Hooks the leg. 1-2 now.
Power again.
Got that right arm up and out of there.
In again. What an attack by Kirchner. Look at him.
The big Canadian, too smart for that. Gone to the well one too many times. The corporal. Oh, look what he's doing, Lord. He's adjusting something in that forearm support.
I think he's just about fed up with Kirchner.
He's turned it just about all the way around. There may be some kind of steel plate or something in there. He's saying to the referee, get out of the way, let me do this.
Yeah, and he's intent on doing
it. Or somebody finds out what I've done.
Yes.
Throws him in, here it comes. Oh, blocked! Blocked by Kirchner! Kirchner now with a boot, look at it. Oh, Kirchner! Rammed his own forearm into his face. He got him! The best plans of mice and men.
It suddenly all went wrong for Iron Mike there. Things were looking so good until he loaded his own arm and it was turned against him.
Let's get the official word.
The winner of this bout, Corporal Kirchner.
Corporal Kirchner, hard-fought victory here in the Boston Gardens. Just double-crossed himself. Let's go back and take a look at what happened to Iron Mike.
Mike looking for something there. Whatever it was, he put it down inside. That leather protector he wears for his wrist on the right arm, making sure it's well and truly tucked down there where the referee cannot see it. And now he's obviously got designs for putting that right to the head of Kirchner.
Maybe told the referee to, hey, step out of the way, let me do this thing. I'm about to do my thing here. But things backfire as the corporal comes off, he hooks that right arm. And once he stops him and plants a boot into his midsection, he rams his own forearm right into his forehead. Knocked him right in the middle of next week. hooks the leg. Referee right there for the three count. Corporal on the victory. We'll be back. Strongest man being announced from Boston, and tremendous ovation here.
Well, gosh.
He will be one of the participants in the 20-man open invitational battle royal, part of WrestleMania 2, direct out of the Rosemont Horizon, Chicago. He'll be in there with some tough cookies. And he'll get an education as well as a lot of other guys, Lord.
Yes, he's due for a big, big education in there, and let's hope that it furthers his career, because you know, he's a very willing young man. And
well, it's one thing to go down there and press 705 and a half pounds and set the all-time world's record. Unfortunately, that 705 pounds wasn't kicking and biting and scratching and trying to maim you.
No, and if he gets a couple of thumps from Big John Studd, he'll know what's happened to
Well, just him for sure. Barry O setting up on that top turnbuckle. Pride and joy of Las Vegas, Nevada. Has on the back of his ring robe, Lord, a royal flush. Straight. Like to have that on a number of occasions.
Oh, gosh. Yes, that'd have been a lot.
Could
more
do considerable damage with that, yes. Arcidi outsmarting Berrio, which I did not expect to see.
No. And
Hey, Arcidi going right after him. I don't believe he'll catch him.
No, but for a big man, he certainly moves very fast. Showed a little inexperience there, though.
Well, that's the only problem. When you have all that brute power, you got to know what to do with it.
Yes.
I've seen a lot of huge, large, powerful individuals get in the ring and really take somebody like a Berrio, make you look like a fool. Lord.
That can happen. That really can happen. And if anybody will make you look like a fool, it could be Berrio, because he doesn't look terribly powerful, but he has that sinew strength that is really, really awesome.
Well, you know what's going to happen here, Lord. Berrio is going to keep fooling around in there. He's going to make Arcidi upset, and Arcidi is going to explode, and Berrio will be in the showers.
The point about Arcidi is that he's won all of his belts on strength, but even so, he's gaining a little knowledge every time he fights.
Look at this. Oh, nice reversal.
Strong, powerful reversal.
Look at this, Lord. He dropped the ringlets off of his ring attire, which shows me that Arcidi has had about enough of Berrio.
Yes. Actually, he's working on a short fuse.
Oh, the bell. Well, got a thumb right in the eye immediately. Smart maneuver by Berrio. Doesn't take long for Arcidi to make you say, ouch, I do. Look when he slaps the bear on a clothesline.
Oh, that massive great arm.
Looking for some kind of confirmation from the ringsiders.
Tari's gonna get another one, I think.
No. Oh, there's a bear hug the second time. And still he's got that chin up in the air. Oh, Berrio said that's it. I don't blame him.
Those powerful, powerful arms. Could stand a bear hug.
Most impressive victory here in the Boston Gardens with a hometown favorite, Ted Arcidi. Let's get the official word.
The winner of the match, the world's strongest man, Ted Arcidi.
You know, Laura, take a good look at him. His biceps are bigger than his calves.
Yes, he is just a massive, massive
a mountain of a man, Ted Arcidi. Let's go back and take a look at the devastating bear hug. Second time around, first time he got a thumb in the eye. Right here, there was no, you know, it might have behooved him if he just dipped that head a little bit, Lord.
Yes,
get those eyes out of sight, but Berrio didn't waste any time in saying, let me out of this.
quickly.
Take a look at him. World's strongest human, Ted Arcidi. Don't go away. We'll be back. You crazy?
Sit down, brother. Don't let them distract you at all. Sit
this
down,
is a
keep your cool. Wow!
Team number two from Charlotte, North Carolina, 270 pounds. And from Venice Beach,
California, 302 pounds. Oh, there they come! Junkyard Dog and World's Heavyweight Champion, Hulk Hogan. Tremendous competition here for the Funk Brothers.
This place is going
absolutely insane. Oh, they're juking and doing their thing. Boston Garden erupting here with enthusiasm. Talk about your hot teams. You're looking at one right there. Hulkster. And the Junkyard Dog.
Just look at this place. 20,000 people on their feet. Just screaming and roaring their approval and their support for Hulk Hogan and the Junkyard Dog. And right now the Funks are on the outside of the ring and they don't want to get into it.
Somebody will have to get in. Capacity crowd on its feet chanting Hogan.
Lock out.
Hanging up with a Junkyard Dog's chain. And now it's wrapped around the neck of Hoss. As a champion whips Terry into the turnbuckle. Referee Danny Davis will have one hell of a time trying to assemble any order here in this match. Look at the dog.
Oh, look at this. They're going to bounce his head off the dogs.
Oh, the champion rams the head of Terry Funk right into the Junkyard Dog. Finally, we got two men out and two men in.
And Hoss Funk, he's made a mistake. He found himself in there by himself. And I don't think he likes that situation.
Uh-oh, he's got the branding iron. Terry, the crazy one. Referee Danny Davis made him turn it loose, or this match would have been over in a hurry.
I think it would, and no matter what happens here, I believe that Hulk Hogan and Junkyard Dog have definitely outpsyched the Funk Brothers.
Mouth of the South will certainly have his hands full here, as the Funks have not met any competition like this, Lord.
No, definitely not. The competition they have met, so far they've steamrolled right over the top of them. They've ridden roughshod over everybody, but I don't think they're going to do this to Hulk Hogan and Junkyard Dog.
Terrible Terry trying to entice the dog back towards his own corner. Dog's too smart for that. In the meantime, lurking in the background, Hoss waiting for an opportunity.
Yes, and I don't think Terry will win a tug of war against Junkyard Dog either.
No, and now he's got him into a neutral corner. Look out. Nice reversal there by Terrible Terry. Follows him in, but nobody there. And rams that left shoulder right into the steel post. He's going to turn around and see the Hulk there, and he's going to panic.
Yes.
Come on, Terry. Come on, baby. Come on now.
that megaphone screaming out encouragement. Oh, that's a mistake.
That is not a good thing for Terry
the
Funk to do.
The dog loves that. Look at this. Terrible Terry's going to knock himself out. Dog now boom. Proceeding to ram him time after time into that top turnbuckle as 20,000 plus count on. Oh, he went right over and tagged brother. Says, please, give me a break. That horse in there now quickly as a crisscross. Who will change? Who will turn around? The dog stops. And Haas keeps going. The dog
Haas.
Is just watching
Haas
him.
Haas is a horse. Look at Terry's he's saying it's a relay now. Race.
Look at he doesn't know what's going on. A drop kick missed by Haas.
Oh, they're wild, these Texans, but at the moment, it's not doing them any good at all.
Well, I'm sure whatever game plan they had in mind went out the window a long time ago, Lord.
I think so. They were thwarted right at the beginning there, and there. Hulk hasn't even got into the ring yet.
Slightly discombobbled. The Mouth of the South needs to take his team aside and try to get them back together into some kind of rhythm, because they're not going to beat this duo the way they're operating
not
right
like
now.
Not like that. No, definitely not. But they are rough and they are tough. So
well, they have tremendous tag team ability.
They do.
Oh, there's a big champion in there now. With a side headlock. And does he look in great shape?
Doesn't he, though?
Still got doesn't those he? Ribs bandaged up a little bit on the lower short ribs. A save made in there by JYD. Smart thinking on the part of the dog.
Good tag team work. Good team, these two. Hulk Hogan and Junkyard Dog.
Well, everybody saw the annihilation that was done on Hulk Hogan on the Saturday night main event out of Phoenix, Arizona, as he was Pearl Harbored by King Kong Bundy
and teamed
and literally
up on.
Sent to the hospital.
Yes. And he had soft tissue damage there, so I don't know if he'll be fully recovered from that.
Well, he's showing me some. Look at this. Oh, look at that. Terry Funk tried to save his partner, but it was a reversal by Haas, and Terrible Terry got the worst of it again.
He got a boot right to the stomach for his pains there.
He's upset.
And he doesn't like that. But they can certainly take some punishment, these Funk brothers. I've seen them. They
the
are
going over there
resilient.
Trying to get Terrible Terry. He's going after some ringsider here. It looks like now he's attacking the barricade.
And that's not going to hurt the barricade.
Brother Haas saying, look, the match is over in this direction.
Yeah, well, the Haas is the brains of this team, you know. And Funk is, I don't know what you would call him, he's the wild man.
He's all tangled up with something over there.
He's got those electric cords all wrapped around his boots. Haas is saying, calm down, Terry, calm down.
Oh, he's after some of those Japanese photographers. Well, you can take the boy out of the country, Lord, but you can't take the country out of the boy.
No. Amarillo's pride up there.
Haas back in there once again. Shoulder block by the champion. Neither man budge. Oh, squint for a scoop slam. Nice block by Hulkster. And the Hulk scoops him up. And here comes Terrible Terry.
And
he's scooped up as well. And a third slam for Haas. And one more for Terrible Terry.
Yes.
And there go the Funk Brothers. Capacity crowd on his feet loving it.
Oh, he has such charisma combined with such skill that he makes these people come alive as he does everywhere in the world.
Well, the Mouth of the South having a reunion over there outside the ring. Saying, probably saying, what are you guys doing?
Yes. Just look at the Hulk.
This is not our game plan. A good shot there of the lariat still left in the corner. And the Hulkster went flying out of there on those bad ribs. Look out! Oh, Terry with a steel chair right into the kidney area of the champion. Not the place to be, Lord.
Not with two steel chairs that are together.
Oh, look at that random with a steel branding iron right in his short ribs. Already severely injured by King Kong Bundy. And now it's Haas going to work on the chair.
Hulk was trying to protect that, and I'm afraid trying to protect it, he left himself open for an attack in another area, and now he's vulnerable to all these attacks.
Quick tag made by Hoss. Is now Terrible Terry's in there, and he knows how to administer that punishment. Boy, once they get the upper hand on you, they're relentless. They won't stop.
Those big fists of Terry just pounding into Funk now, into Hulk, I should say.
Champ needs to get over there and make a tag to the dog. Oh, look at this. Uh-oh. The Hulkster is hulking up. Those lefts aren't bothering him anymore. Wow, big roundhouse right. And another one. And another one as Terrible Terry goes reeling. There's a tag made to the dog. Big right hand right in the lower abdomen area. Terrible Terry in for the ride once more. Oh, what a clothesline.
Great clothesline. Floored Terry. And he's not moved. Ah! Wow. But he moved in time then. You can never tell with the Funk Brothers. They are absolutely unpredictable.
Couldn't see whether a tag was made there or not, Lord. I guess so, because the referee's letting Hoss stay in there.
Powerful uppercut by Funk, yeah. Horse Funk, that is.
Stepped right on the face of the Junkyard Dog. Uppercut, beautifully thrown.
The Hoss Funk, the elder of the brothers, is very much more controlled than the wild one, Terry, and he'll hurt you. He'll hurt you really badly.
In there once again. Double team effort here now by the Funks. Dog goes in. Wow. Hulkster can't stand it anymore. He's coming in. And a blatant chokehold while referee Danny Davis distracted in putting the champion out. Dog's in bad shape, Lord.
He is, and you've got two big, big Texans beating on him. He's bound to be in some sort of bad shape. But he's resilient. Nice!
Desperation suplex.
Junkyard Dog got himself out of some trouble with that suplex because it did stop Terry Funk, but not for long.
I still think Terry's in the better shape of the two that are in there. Oh, that's a mistake.
Junkyard
he
Dog.
He keeps going to that, Lord.
Just looking
at
him.
Look, he thinks he's in his
own
corner.
Goes. Boom!
Hello. Terrible Terry trying to make the tag. He didn't make it. The Hulkster's in there. And Terry steps in, and he gets caught with one.
Turnbuckle.
Look out. Terry upside down in the corner, just hanging there now. At the mercy of the champion. Wow, went over and gave Hoss a shot.
Hoss trying to mind his own business. He caught a right-hander from Hulk Hogan. Lift him up.
Uh-oh, look at this. Back shot. Oh, right in that already injured kidney area of the champion. He is hurt. Look at Terrible Terry's got some tape wrapped around the throat of the champion. He's over. He can reach the dog. He made the tag. Uh-oh, referee didn't see it. Danny Davis putting out the dog. In the meantime, Hoss steps in. Illegal man inside the ring. As they're really both going to work now on the back of the champion.
Two headbutts, one to Hoss, one to Terry. And it looks like he may have saved the day there for Hulk Hogan because Hulk is obviously suffering from that injury.
Oh, no! Yes! Hey! Up on the apron, the mouth of the south, and he's grabbed by the Junkyard Dog. And uh-oh, look out, the lariat. Oh, wrapped around the neck of the Junkyard Dog as he is being hung there by the Funks. Hoss holding the legs and Terry pulling for all he's worth. Look out, here comes the champ. Oh, what a clothesline. Down on top of Terry, what? I don't believe that Terry Funk was the legal man in the ring, Lord.
Well, the referee turned around and all he saw
was
Terry Funk being
picked. 1, 2, 3. And there goes Hoss. Boy, did things backfire for them.
Well, that was quite a mix-up there, Gorilla, and I can't blame referee Danny Davis there because all he saw were the shoulders down.
Well, it was pandemonium here in a Boston Garden as everything that could happen did happen. And the Funk Brothers come up with a short end of the stick. Let's get the official word.
The winners of this match, the team. team of the Junkyard Dog and Hulk Hogan.
Well, I know for a fact, Lord, that there was a champion, Hulk Hogan, who was the legal man in the ring, but I'm a little confused. I think Hoss was the legal man on the other team.
I'm pretty sure it was. So
the referee obviously didn't know what was going down. But there's a very dynamic duo right there. World's heavyweight champion Hulk Hogan and the Junkyard Dog.
Absolutely, and Junkyard Dog possibly being number two in the world next to Hulk Hogan. What a fantastic team.
Hulkster pulling off those bandages from around his waist, that lower rib area, that kidney area, that was injured so severely at the hands of King Kong Bundy. And that score will be settled April 7th, WrestleMania 2, in the steel cage.
Look at him, the finest professional athlete in the world. The greatest professional athlete in the world.
Oh, look at that. The dog said, go ahead, champ, give it to him. And the champ obliging the 20,000 plus here in the Boston Garden. Talk about charisma. This guy has it personified.
He has it in excelsis, Gorilla. And who can blame all these people for not leaving this stadium, because they're going to wait. They want every last second of eye contact with the greatest professional athlete in the world. What has he got here?
The dog is looking for some jukers. Uh-oh, what's a champ got? Oh! And another champion! As the dog gives a little posing demonstration with a mask of the Hulk. Oh my God, what a tremendous team.
Aren't they just wonderful, those two? How can you do anything else but absolutely love them?
Unbelievable combination, the Junkyard Dog teaming up with Hulk Hogan, the world's heavyweight champion, as they really did a number on the Funk Brothers. Let's go back and take a look.
There we see Junkyard Dog there engaging Hoss, but while his back is turned, Terry crept up on him, put that lariat around his neck, and now...
Well, you see that, Lord. Terry came from the corner.
Absolutely.
He was not the legal man in the ring.
He was on the outside.
And here's the champ out on the floor.
Meanwhile, the referee is tied up there with Jimmy.
What's this clothesline? Wow.
Now he turns around. You see, all he sees is him being
pinned. All he sees is legs up in the air. He can't see whose face it is. Well, it'll still go down in the record books as a victory for the world's champion, Hulk Hogan, and the Junkyard Dog. Hold down the hatches. We'll be back. Well, wrestling fans, Lord, I'm exhausted. We've seen it all here this week on the New England Sports Network. The champion, Hulk Hogan, with his new partner, the Junkyard Dog, really doing a number on the Funk Brothers.
Very, very close to it. In fact, I mean, you could argue the point there and say that they didn't lose that much at all.
Don't forget, wrestling fans, coming up April 7th, a Monday night, the biggest wrestling extravaganza of all time, WrestleMania 2. Gorilla Monsoon for the Lord saying, so long until next time.
Cheerio.